that we now have.
Experts in the banking sector have revealed that the economy is getting better despite the previous sector challenges that saw the acquisition of Crane Bank by DFCU Group. Currently, the economic growth is averaging at 5%, an improvement from 4.6% as at June 2016. As at June 2017, the average of non-performing loans stands at 6%, an improvement from 8.3% last year.
The non-performing loans in the market are gradually reducing. As you can see, it had topped at 8.7%, it's now at around 6%, and we believe that this should be able to go down to the old levels of about 3%. Now, if these non-performing loans go down those levels, that means that the banks will also be more comfortable to once again do their cardinal duty, which is to lend.
DFCU Chief Finance Officer Kate Kiza revealed that the bank fully integrated the Crane Bank system into its own and noted that only some of the assets and liabilities from the now defunct Crane Bank were acquired.
The assumption of the customer deposits is very important because it ensured that if you had 1 shilling in Crane, you never got a coin less, a cent less, when it moved over to DFCU. Just to note, the claims against shareholders, related parties to Crane Bank, insider loans, those were not acquired by DFCU Bank. Just important to highlight those, that those are among the certain assets and certain liabilities that were not taken on. Similarly, employee-related liabilities were not taken on, and tax liabilities were also not taken on.
Generally, the total assets for both DFCU and Stanbic Bank increased, while Stanbic Bank registered a slight drop in profit as DFCU's profit increased 5 times following the Crane Bank's acquisition. For Urban TV, I'm Martin Kwagala.
And where we closed the year, this is where we closed the year.